Hello children, welcome back to your English class. Today we are going to start with the poem Beauty of your Honeysuckle book, written by E. Ashwar, well, Louis Abatha Quivi. It is written C-H-E-W-I-W-I, but it's pronounced as Quivi in her language. E. Ashwar's pen name is E. Ashwar, but her actual name was Louis Abatha Quivi. She is also known as Blue Corn. She was born on September 9 in 1926, was a Puebloan writer, poet and educator. She was a teacher also, who was an enrolled member of Isleta Pueblo. Isleta Pueblo is a place in New Mexico in United States. Louis Abatha was born and raised as Isleta Pueblo, New Mexico in United States. Her father Diogo Abatha was active in tribal government. Her mother was Lottie Gone Abatha. When she was 13 years old, just this poet, when she was 13 years old, her first book, the illustrated I Am a Pueblo Indian Girl, was published. So this E. Ashwar had a long career in teaching, and she remained active in the Native American education system even long after her teaching career was over. She was retired, but she remained in that education system. Louis Abatha died in July 2014 in United States itself. So she is the poet of the poem we are going to read. Introduction of the poem is that in this poem, beauty has been defined. It has been given a definition that what beauty actually is. The poet says that the beauty is there in everything. Now, to know more about this, let's just read the poem. Coming back to the very first stanza, beauty is seen in the sunlight, the trees, the birds, corn growing, and people working or dancing for their harvest. Yes, truly nicely said that the beauty is seen by the eyes. The beauty is in the eyes of the beholder. The one who is seeing something, he should have or she should have beauty in their eyes to notice that there is beauty in everything. It is the attitude of a person, what attitudes he or she keeps towards that thing or that scene or that particular person he's seeing to. Beauty is everywhere. It can be seen in the sunlight, in the trees, in the birds flying around, the growing crops, people who dance to show their happiness when their crops are ready. Obviously, people like farmers who work so hard in order to harvest some, when they harvest that particular crop which they have worked hard for, and when that harvesting takes place, it is a joy, it is a joyous moment for them to celebrate. So that's why they dance and celebrate the harvesting sometimes. So beauty is there also, beauty is in their dancing too. Second sentence of the poem says that beauty is heard in the night, wind sighing, rain falling, or a singer chanting anything in earnest. Anything in earnest means that earnest, meaning of earnest is to have a sincere conviction to something, to have a sincere belief. So whatever the singer is singing, you feel the belief and sincere conviction into his or her singing. So in the last stanza, the poet was saying that the beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder, and in second stanza, the poet is saying that beauty can be heard. Beauty is a thing to be felt. It can be heard means one can listen to it, like one can hear its sounds when night falls, when the wind is blowing and creates a sound. When wind blows, it's create a kind of sound, and that is also a kind of beauty according to the poet. When the rain falls on the earth, when a singer is singing, one can even feel it in sincere and honest conviction of a person. That means if a singer is singing with so much heart, there is a beauty to his or her singing. We can feel the sincere and honest conviction of the person. Our next and last stanza of the poem is, beauty is in yourself. Good deeds, happy thoughts that repeats themselves in your dreams, in your work, and even in your rest. That means beauty is in you. Beauty is not outside. Beauty is not anywhere to be like noticed or anything. Beauty is inside your eyes. Beauty is inside you. Beauty is not always external or visible. It is within, and it can be abstract. Beauty is not always visible. Beauty is there. That's why the poet is saying that it is abstract, because it has to be felt. One's views, good acts, good deeds means good acts, what you do good for others. One's wishes, which which one even imagines in dreams. Okay, so all that you do good comes to yourself. So that is the beauty of life. Beauty can be one way of work or even the style of taking rest. Thus, beauty is very vast. The concept of beauty is very vast. It cannot be confined to one thing, that this is beautiful or that is beautiful or Taj Mahal is only beautiful. No, everything is beautiful. It's just you have to see the beauty in everything what you see or do. Rather, it is everything there in everything. We just need eyes and heart to see it. Rather, it is there in everything. It is the beauty lies in everything, according to the poet. Through this poem, the poet has depicted the concept of beauty. That concept of beauty is not just remained or confined to one thing or one person or one scenery, one view. No, everything is beautiful. If sunrise is beautiful, the sunset is equally beautiful. If the sound of water flowing fast is beautiful, even the pitter patter of the rain is also beautiful. So according to the poet, what you see, what you feel, and if you have a beauty in your eyes to see the beauty of others, see the beauty of other things outside, that means everything is beautiful. So beauty is everywhere. This is the summary of the poem. So what I want you to now is pause the video and read the summary once again. So when you are finished with the summary, you will be able to understand the poem very, very better. Thank you so much for listening to the video. I hope you understood the poem. Take care, everyone. I'll be seeing you next class with another chapter. Bye bye.